I'm so eager right now to try this for the first time. Okay, I think we just need to get into it. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today I wanted to try a pumpkin spice latte inspired eye look and just play around with some makeup with you all. Some new, some old. And today is also a very special day because I will be trying my first pumpkin spice latte ever. This is years in the making. We'll see what the hype is. Some people say it does not live up to the hype, but we're gonna find out my opinion live. Oh, there's my little name, hello. I also have a bonus drink in there that is a recipe, of course, from TikTok. I'm actually kind of nervous, but also excited. Today's video is in partnership with Collab Makeup. They are supporting the channel and they have been for a long time now because I am one of the 8 members of their Collab Collective, which is a group of 8 influencers that help guide the brand in their products they are developing. So my longtime viewers know, but if you're new here, there you go. Collab Makeup is exclusively sold at Sally Beauty. And today we're gonna be starting off with some color correcting because in my recent makeup videos, this skull has been driving me nuts when I'm contouring. It's really just peeking through a lot of my formulations. So this is one of our color correctors. This is the No Flaws Liquid Concealer in Dark Peach. I say it every time. This concealer is basically like my baby because I really wanted one. And I initiated like, hey, I need color correctors that are great formula. So this is super pigmented and really affordable. Usually you can't get both really affordable and super pigmented together, but we mastered that because affordable ones I've tried blend away, don't correct. And then the more expensive ones, you know, break the bank. This formulation sets an average time. I don't color correct all the time, but I do have certain prominent scars, and I feel like that really helps those areas before we apply foundation. I'm using the Sephora Pro Concealer 57 brush. I'm sure I'll get questions. Concealer brushes are always a very popular topic. And I'm gonna press this into the skin with a stippling motion while also kind of just blending out. It ends up a lot larger, I know, but it's okay. Cause it's that pigmented, just a little dab gets you quite a bit. I actually wanna compare this to the Dragon Beauty formula, but it's typically always sold out and I haven't tried it, I haven't got my hands on it, but I'm pretty impressed with ours. So it'd be nice to see how they compare. I'm gonna feather this out into my hairline just so it doesn't stop right before and give us like a weird edge. If you haven't color corrected before, a darker orange or a darker peach typically corrects bluer, purpler tones. It's the opposite on the color wheel. Typically they say blue, but usually if you have like darker circles that kind of look, you know, bluish, purplish, that helps a lot as well. I obviously don't need it right now. I do have a little discoloration, but for the most part, regular concealer's fine. I of course have my little bit of discoloration. I slept at 6 a.m. last night. Not smart, so running on a little bit of sleep, but I do have eye filler, so I think regular concealer will do fine. I think my eye filler is, yeah, 3 months old now, so still going. I'm gonna take this no crease concealer and clip my hair back. I usually use 2. You'll probably see me switch sides throughout the video because I have these little cowlicks, and though I can't master all of them to lay how I want to, I'll just move them around like after heat styling. They just like to do what they want to do. It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. Now that we've corrected, we're gonna move into our foundation and our concealer. I'm gonna be using Too Faced today. We got the Born This Way Matte in the shade Sand and the Born This Way Multi Sculpt Concealer in Shortbread. This is for our highlighted points. Right after pumping out my foundation, I realized I didn't want to take a little bit of translucent powder and put it over concealer just so we can set it lightly, not too much, very, very small amounts, just so it doesn't move off of the areas that I really want it to stay. I do this sometimes, it's like a 50-50. However I'm feeling that day. And you guys already know this powder. It's well used and loved on this channel. This is the Collab Makeup Set the Stage Soft Focus Loose Powder. She's bomb, and we will be setting our highlight areas with that as well. It's the most amazing fine, glowy, without being glittery formula, and like a light yellow shade, perfect for my tones. She's probably MVP powder of the year. For foundation, I'm gonna apply it with more of like a kitty paw style brush. This is the 47 Sephora brush, and we are going to bring it around town. I'm also gonna bring the foundation down my neck because this did fit me 2 months ago. I feel like it's kind of still there, but when we're zoomed in close, my neck just looks abnormally different than the rest of my face, especially without the concealer on. It's that time of year where I'm in between summer and winter shades. forehead just ended up like this weird situation and shape, and then I missed a spot on this eye. Hello. We're gonna put this on, and since this concealer doesn't set fast and actually covers a little bit more if you have it sit there for a moment, I'm gonna put a little bit of nose contour on before we blend out. I'm gonna try to use Faux Tan by Bare Minerals. This is their Bare Pro Glow Bronzer. It's a liquid one. A lot of my cream products are not looking the same on my current skin tone, so. You guys see that? The color is basically my foundation, so that was kind of pointless. Faux Tan is actually me currently, at least in this foundation. I'm gonna use a sponge to blend out the concealer. My sponge is feeling a little dry, so I'm gonna try to add a little moisture with the Fenty Beauty Spray. I'm not sure why that sponge was not doing it for me, but I just grabbed a different one that was also kind of damp. It was just feeling really weird. I don't know, it might need to be washed again. We need just a little more right here, because that side didn't end up as even. And then just a small amount, small amount in the middle of the nose to highlight. I think that's looking pretty good. I'm debating if I want to do more of a brightening area, but I think what we got, the angle we got, is looking pretty good. So let's hop into our powder again. See the soft focus from the powder. I know it looks a little dramatic right now, but once we, you know, finish the rest of our face, bronze, and get all of everything else done, we'll blend it all together with some blush and some highlight. Just trust the process, y'all. Let's flip to the other side with our hair clip and give that some love. I'm gonna set my face quickly. I like to usually set right here and come back and do the cheeks later. This is the Collab Makeup Grand Finale Hydrating Setting Mist. While that dries, let's talk about our brows. They look pretty good right now. They're soaped up. I want to do a few strokes towards the bottom just for extra definition. With Collab's Shape and Shade Brow Pencil, this is the Ultra Fine in Warm Brown. And I'm just going to lay it right along the bottom line of my brow. Majority of the product on the outside of like my pupil towards the outside of my brow. I didn't want too much definition towards the front just because I've been, you know, fluffier lately. I just want to be a little fluff, a little bit more negative space between the hairs. Eye base, we're just gonna do concealer, the NARS Soft Matte Complete. You guys already know, been using it a lot. This is in Custard. All right, let's get into all the fun with the eyes. This is the Morphe Brush Lust Set. This is a holiday collection item. Comes with 10 different brushes, and I'll probably be using the majority of these. They have these nice little gold handles, and it seems like they're pretty good quality. We'll test them out. They have a good variety. It comes with this silicone paddle. I don't know if this is for lips. It looks like a lip balm scooper from other things I have around the house. I don't know if you could do a little crease concealer action or whatever have you. There's a bunch of fluffier brushes, angled, tapered, round, a flat shader brush, and then like a really, really skinny angled brush. So for the most part, you've got a bunch of creases in different sizes and shapes, and then these three little detailed situations. Taking one of the bigger brushes from the group that does not have a number, but it's a flat at the top, I guess you could say. This is going to apply from the e.l.f. Cream and Sugar palette. The lightest shade to me is a great setting shade for my lid. It's not too bright, but it really helps blend later. The brushes are super light and super soft. I'm typically a fan of Morphe's. Depending on the collection you get, I'm pretty cool with it. We also have one of the holiday lip sets to try out. And I have the palette. They were nice enough to send me the collection. They don't always send me all of their PR, but they did send me holiday. And I can't wait to play around with that palette. It doesn't go with our theme today, but you'll definitely see me using it soon, whether it be here or IG, so make sure you follow both. Their holiday palette's more like pinkies and plums. It's very cute, very cute. I have a bunch of different palettes on the table right now. Obviously, we're not hopping into any of the neons, but maybe some of these warmer browns. This is a Melt Cosmetics palette that I bought for a dupes video, which will eventually show up in your sub box. This is actually from April because it's their 420 palette. It's really cool. That's a little holograph. Woo! And Collab Makeup has a really awesome orange in the Sunset Dream palette, so we're definitely using her at some point. She's bomb diggity. Love her. Fenty has this number 5 peach palette. She got tones. We've used her before as well. The Morphe palette has a few browns for us to possibly play in, but we can't use too much of it. I also have the It's All Good palette from ColourPop on my table, and they have quite a few cream situations we might be able to use. Probably nothing from the bottom row, but the rest looks pretty good. All right, let's take a look at our gal, our pumpkin spice latte. Ooh, she's like bright. I don't know if you guys can see it because it's, there you go. She's bright. Holy moly. I'm so eager right now to try this for the first time. Okay, I think we just need to get into it. I see the appeal. She's really subtle, soft, not bad at all. It is not over green tea latte for me. I don't really like Starbucks' green tea latte. I like making my own or other places, but this is not bad. It's subtle. I would drink it again if I came across it. Am I gonna be addicted to it? No, I don't think it's enough hype for me to be like, oh, yay. Would I get one a season to be like, oh, like it's back, just like my favorite Panera salad that only comes in the summertime? Sure, not too much like, spice, not too much pumpkin, a lot of milky. I'm cool with it. I'm not a big coffee drinker. I like lattes, so this is right up my alley. I don't mind. She's approved. Is she a little overrated because she's super hyped? I don't know. I don't know if I can hop on that bus yet, but I do agree that she's very hyped. Let's start with Bellini Baby from Fenty Beauty first because it's a little lighter than the collab, and I think this will give us a nice dimension. We're gonna put this into the crease with a really light hand and a fluffier brush that's not too fat. I'm gonna take the lightest shade from the Sunset Dreams palette, and it might be a little subtle right now, but we'll highlight the brow bone with that. We might need a little bit of a lighter color. Really flawless, smooth look currently. Maybe just a little bit of No Worries from ColourPop at the top, just so it's not super bright. This brush is huge. I feel like it's a bad idea. I feel like it's getting in my brow. Right into the orange from the Sunset Dreams palette. That into the crease right underneath the other shade. We're just gonna make sure this color really has her moment and you can see her because it's beautiful. I'm actually really dragging it into this inner eyelid area. Since it's such a light wash, I'd rather it just kind of blend forward. Just gonna hug whatever inner corner color we put there later. I really want to try this palette, so let's go into full melt. Use this with a pencil brush and try to apply a little bit at a time. Don't get carried away. This is actually my first time trying Melt Cosmetics at all, and I'm quite impressed. I heard their shadows are very buttery, and it definitely is. I'm not getting fallout, and it's really sticking yet blending where I want it to go. Woohoo! That is so pretty. Okay, I need to stop getting excited because that's when I'm gonna apply it too much. As you can see, I'm kind of dragging it outwards towards the end of my brow, but then bringing it into the crease. So it's kind of like a squished V. Ooh, she did that. Grabbing my crease brush and just blending. I didn't pick up any extra product. I just want to make sure it's blended where my eyelid wants to act up. I love it right now. I am in love, and I'm just really hoping I don't screw this up, but I'm gonna manifest that I don't screw this up. I wish there was something else in this palette we could dig into, but I don't think there is right now, so I can't wait to use this in a later video. She came, she saw, she conquered, and it's now time to dive in to these creams, to these top rows. So the silicone is for glitter. The silicone glitter packer brush, obviously for glitter. Firm shadow brush, mini blender brush. Is that it? No. I wish they labeled the brush itself. I think we're gonna use this really tiny brush to get into our lid. Yeah, let's do that. I was gonna go for a lighter concealer, but I'm just gonna use the same custard, a little bit on the brush. I can't be the only one who like applies a little, backs up to look at it, and then keeps applying. I got this. Matching, no problem. Little definition, easy breezy. There's a lot of affirmations in this video too. So I wiped the brush off the best I can so we can prepare it to also apply the shade from the It's All Good palette. We're gonna start with Carefree because it's a little lighter. She's cute. I mean, she's a little yellowy. That's what we wanted. We wanted more of a yellowy cream because of, you know, the trees, the vibes. The color of the latte has a very strong yellow tint to it. Gives me turmeric meets pumpkin vibes. We'll fix like where the shadows meet in a second. I just wanna make sure the lids lay right. We're gonna blend very gently without picking up any extra product where they meet. This is a crease brush. Make sure the lid color just knows where she is sitting. Your desk is over here, honey. Welcome to the class. I think it's just so different. Like, I don't know why I dislike the shape. I know it's probably not everyone's cup of tea. Absolutely not everyone's cup of tea. I really like this shape. All right, I think we should do our liner and our lashes and then come back to see like what we want to do for the inner corner, what we're going to touch up, like get the angles right first. Then we should lay down a brown liner first. A little bit of the Aqua Resist brown from Makeup Forever. This is Ebony, and I think this would be the best for my waterline. So I'm going to twist it up a little bit. That instantly gave us a fuller lash line, though my lash line ain't that impressive, let's be honest. We're gonna try to add just a little definition using Persona Cosmetics Brown Eyeliner. This is a 24-hour waterproof eye pencil, and I just sharpened her, so hopefully she gives us exactly what we need. So we got a little half line going, and I wanna smudge this a little bit, so that's why I picked this liner, because I do have a lot of other ones, but they set so fast that you can't smudge it. My favorite smudging brush is by Collab Makeup as well, because we have a really nice, dense but short brush. This liner actually looks black, so if you have a black liner, that works well too. I probably should use the lighter brown, but it is what it is. I was dipping very, very lightly, like baby dip, into the Melt Cosmetics color of Roll It. It's kind of cooler tone, but I figured it would work. I'm using the really tiny brush from the set to grab some of the liner so I can get that really, really soft flick, because this flick ended up a little longer. So we're gonna see if we can just turn it into a little slightly soft flick. At least they're both upwards. We'll go with that. They're both, oh, I fall out somewhere on my hand. Oh, Jesus. That was going too smoothly. Now that that's laid, we need to touch up our favorite color, Full Melt, just to make sure she looks really nice and strong right above the liner. I'm gonna apply a coat of the Collab Makeup The Works mascara. This is in Black Brown, our best selling mascara. And afterwards, I'm gonna apply a false lash. What lash? I don't know yet, to be honest, but I'm gonna be using the Velour Lashing Glow. That's what it's called, Lashing Glow. And I will let you guys know right after what lash we end up fitting to these lids. All right, so we're back, and I'm happy to report that the lashes I wanted to try, it's my first time wearing them, from Tati Lashes. This is the TL21. I've worn one of their other styles, which was way more dramatic on me, but this is the perfect level of drama for this look. It's like a lower lash with a flare. I'll show you guys what they look like before I put them on. I did trim off a good amount of the dramatic flare because one, it didn't fit my eyes, and two, I think this is just the right amount. As you can see, it's a lower lash to the liner, but it still gives you like, when you look up, but when you're looking straight, it's just, it's perfect for the angles we're working with today. I'm in love. Hopefully my liner looks decently clean. You never know, there's always like a little straggler spot. I tried to fix what we could on our little, what's the word? Fallout, there it is. But you know, it is what it is. So for the lash line, I wanted to try the shade Blunt from this palette. It's a little bit lighter, a little less red, and I'm using the smallest brush from the Morphe set. It's a beautiful shade, and with this brush, it's blending itself. Like, wow. I always like to make sure to bring that color to hug the liner so it flows well upwards. Oh, I think I just hit my eye. I didn't realize how clutch this palette was gonna come in today. For inner corner highlight and face highlight, I wanna use the Collab Makeup's Fairy Nudes Warm Glow palette today for our highlight. It comes with a bunch of gold tones, really reflective, really warm, and I love this time of year. It's really, really pigmented. I want to use, I'm in debate of the top two for our inner corner and our face. I feel like we need to go gold, right? So we need to go the lightest color right here. It's a little bit more yellow than it's showing up, but color, I'm applying just the smallest amount at a time so I don't regret it. Part of me thinks we should just mix the two. Yeah, we should mix the two. So I'm gonna grab a little bit of the second. All right, a little blended. There we go. Ooh. I feel like the main tone of the gold is really popping through, but we have a little bit of reflex of like the more orangey vibe. Okay, a fan, a big fan. We need to do our cheek. Two options on my desk right now for cheeks. So we have the more bronzy nude. Oh, this is the wrong one. Oh, but she's made an appearance. It's not what I thought this was, but I'm fine with it too. The She Sincere Monochromatic Blush from Patrick Ta. I wear this a lot, and she would also be a vibe, not bad. And then something a little deeper, which I haven't worn in a little bit, is from ColourPop, and this is Too Cool for School Super Shock Cheek Matte. I think they released this last fall. I think that's too bold though. I don't think it's giving us what we need, so we're just gonna have to go Patrick Ta. He's one of the most used blushes for sure this year. These blushes are really soft and buildable, so you don't have to worry about looking harsh and definitely won't give you any lines. I don't think I'm gonna add any bronzer. I wanna do a little bit of cheek cutting, but not with this powder. This will be too bright. Oh geez, I just grabbed Translucent Honey from Laura Mercier, and I don't know if this is light enough, but we'll try to just give us a little bit of cheek definition. I'm gonna leave it slightly there while I apply the other side. Oh, that might've been too high. Might have been too high. That I don't mind. I think we need a little bit of something around the jawline just so it has definition. I'm just gonna grab just a little bit of bronzer. This is from Laura Mercier and just kind of put it underneath here. Last but not least, we're gonna use the Out and Pout Sweet Tea Lip Trio. I believe it comes with a lip liner, a lipstick, and a lip gloss, and these are all in the shade Sweet Tea. We're gonna line first. Then lipstick. This is a matte lipstick. She's very full. And I mean, it should blend in because it is the same shade. All right, so I think this is really, really full. Do we want to use the gloss? Is it at all lighter? Let's swatch to find out, because otherwise I might want to swap in a lighter gloss. I mean, she's similar. She looks a little lighter. Should we try? Why not? Just try. It was a good idea, especially with the outfit. This is so fall, and I'm in love with how this came out. Oh my god, we're missing mascara on the lower lash line. How dare I? Super, super happy with how this came out. This has to be the favorite look of the year to date. I like it. It's different. It's still like light and fun with a, you know, more statement lip. It's not too much. In my opinion, the lashes are actually very, very comfortable, and everything came together so well. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this pumpkin spice latte inspired look. I am probably gonna go try this other drink that I found on TikTok. Oh god, it's not as pretty, so I don't think I got it done right, but we'll see how that goes. Thank you guys so, so much for joining me. If you're interested in any of the products that are shown in today's video, I will have them linked off down below. As always, feel free to use my links and be a real one. And don't forget that Collab Makeup is exclusively sold at Sally Beauty, and they are reopened now, thank goodness, so you can go snag some of these goodies. If you wanna watch any of my recent uploads, they're on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button, which is free 99. You can go ahead and click it if you haven't yet and hit that notification bell. Why not just drop a like while you're down there too? I'd appreciate it. That's it for me today, and I will see you guys in a later video.